Welcome to our live training session number 30, part 3. In this video, we're going to take a look at dialing our fuel and spark timing for part throttle operation. We're also going to take a specific look at dialing in our fuel injection timing table so that we're able to achieve the best possible fuel economy using our AEM Infinity. We're going to have a lot to cover, so let's jump into the live training session so we can get started. Welcome back to our live training session here with our Mitsubishi Evo 9. In the last video, we got our idle dialed in, we've got our starting dialed in for a warm engine. So now we're ready to take a look at our part throttle optimization for both fuel, spark, and our fuel injection timing table. So we have a couple things to take a look at in this video. Now, the fuel table that we created in the very first video, this was just a generic fuel table based on volumetric efficiency values that we should see for this particular engine or for any engine in general. So again, 40 to 50% VE at idle, part throttle should be anywhere between 60 to 70% VE. As we move up into the higher loads, it's going to be tapering and going into 100% VE or higher in the boosted areas of operation for our table. Now, a couple things about this before we start to go into do the actual fuel tuning. We have our spark timing here. really conservative. In fact, we've set our entire spark timing table here to 15 degrees in the part throttle area of operation. Now we're going to go in and optimize that in this video, but by having our spark timing really low, it takes away the ability for any kind of knock or pre-ignition to occur. So we can dial in our main VE fuel table first, then we can come back in here and optimize our spark timing. So it's always the order of operations regardless of any kind of engine management you're working with. It doesn't necessarily have to be the Infinity. The other aspect we have going on here is that we do have our lambda feedback that we're utilizing in our tuning process. In fact, here we have our lambda proportional, lambda integral here in our window. In the last video, the proportional table was all zeroed out and we added a value here of 0.2 to let our lambda feedback here start to trim and go and have some feedback and do something before it was just sitting there not really doing much of anything. We're actually going to be using this in our tuning process right now, and we're going to be taking a look at what the lambda feedback is telling us we need to update by depending on where we're at here in the table. So we're going to be focusing in on 0 psi and below in our table. I'm not going to be able to sweep these really light load areas, negative 10 and negative 12 psi of vacuum. I'm not going to be able to get that low, but we're going to focus in here in this range of operation. We're going to go from 2000, we'll go here to 3000, 4000, maybe up even to 5000 RPM. And we're going to just pay attention to what this feedback is showing us, and then I'm going to be updating my table by whatever it's saying. So if it's too rich, I'm going to be taking out some fuel. If it's too lean, I'm going to be adding some fuel. Now, a couple things about editing the fuel table itself. If we're working with the table here, we want to update, let's say, this area. We want to add some fuel. If we hit the plus button, that's going to be going in and adding 8% of fuel. The minus button's going to be taking 8% out. If we do shift plus, that's going to be going in and adding approximately 10% fuel. Shift minus, taking 10% fuel out. So we can make really large changes using the shift plus or small changes using just the plus or minus. So that's usually how I do my editing process in the table. Not a whole lot to it, just again, paying attention to what my feedback is showing me and then just actually going in and updating the table by that amount. Now, remember, before you do anything else, that you have to have your lambda table here figured out already. Now, in this case, I'm gonna be shooting for values of 15, 14, or 13 air fuel, depending on where I'm at in the load in the table here. So we've already dialed.
Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.